So this mode of Raj. So the primal mode in Vrindavan. In this material world, Parakya, Paramar mode is something very degraded, like something very low. But in transcendental world, it's very high thing, the highest thing. Whatever we see in this world, which is very low, like degraded, in spiritual world is the highest thing. And whatever is like also like very low in the spiritual world, here in this world, it's the highest thing. So this material world is called the perverted reflection of the spiritual world. So imagine our shadow. Shadow looks like us, isn't it? But it's like opposite, completely like opposite. It's not as it is. So in the same way, whatever is there in the transcendental world, it's also in this world. But how? In a perverted reflection. Perverted. So this aprakrita parakyabhava, transcendental paramour mood. Is the highest thing in the spiritual world. And in this world is something very low, like very degraded, very low. Because this world is contaminated by Maya. Whatever we see here is contaminated by Maya. But in that world, transcendental world, there's not even the smell of Maya there. Bhagavan Sri Hari in his dham, Maya cannot even touch, cannot even touch Lord Hari and his dham. So in that world there's not any lusty desire or whatever. Whatever is there in that world is for the happiness of Krishna. So everybody just do everything, does everything for the happiness of Krishna. But in this world, whatever we do is for our own happiness. Because everything in this world is temporary also, it's like changeable. But in the transcendental world, nothing changes, like everything... But because in this world of Maya, everything transforms or perverts. So here's perverted reflection of the spiritual world. So that's why this world is called the perverted reflection of the spiritual world. It means that whatever is there in the spiritual world is also here, but in a perverted way, perverted way.
Srimad Bhagavad Purana Amalam Prema Pumartha Mahan Aur Hamari Arad Hamari Uddeshya Kya
Hai And what is our goal? How can we attain to Krishna Prem?
Kama Moksha Ke Upar Dete Hai
So, which is beyond common moksha. Actually, in the spiritual world, the mukti is seen as something very insignificant. So, Bhagavan says, these four kinds of liberation, Salokya, Srasti, my devotees, they don't want to accept this. These muktis. Lord says. And there's another mukti, Sayuja mukti. Like one is with Lord, that the Mayavadi people, they want. Like Advaitavadi, the monists, they want. The devotees of Krishna, they don't want it. They don't want the devotees of Lord. They don't even want Vaikuntha Bhakti. Not even Ayodhya Bhakti also. So,
वृक्ष लता से लेकर के पशु पक्षी मनुष्य आदि सभी के साथ उन्होंने मिले।
I think Uddhava, no, he stayed in Vraj for 10 months and he met everyone in Vraj, the animals, the trees, the creepers.
और मिलकर के उन्होंने देखा।
And he saw
जे वृंदावन के पशु पक्षी से लेकर के
that even the animals of Vrindavan, even
वृंदावन के मनुष्य तक
human beings
सुबल सिद्धा नंद जसोदा
Like he saw the prema, the sweetness of prema of all of them. And in his heart, he felt this eagerness. Oh, I want also one ray of this prema to come in my heart. So that's why Uddhava of six verses, he explains this.
Vrindavane kimo ke gulmo lato usidena, ja dustaja sajana arja patanche hitva,
मुझे
प्राप्ति हो
टू गेट द फुट डस्ट ऑफ द लोटस फीट ऑफ श्रीमती राधिका
चरण धूरी क्या है
व्हाट इज द चरण धूरी द फुट डस्ट इज हर मूड हर स्वीट मूड स्वीटनेस मूड हर भाव
मुझे जानी चरण धूलि के कार्य
सो व्हेन वी से फुट डस्ट सो ही वांटेड टू गेट दिस उद्धवा
क्योंकि
बिकॉज़
गोपियां किस प्रकार सब कुछ त्याग देकर के
हाउ द गोपीज दे हैव गिवन अप एवरीथिंग देयर पेशेंस देयर प्राइड देयर
संस्कृत आत्मा
यू नो देयर
ऐसे ना होता ना हुई सब
लाइक अ चेस्टिटी एवरीथिंग एंड दे कंप्लीटली सरेंडर टू कृष्णा Like they gave up all these things and they completely surrendered to Krishna. So the gopis, they gave up everything. Their shyness, their pride, their patience, and they completely surrendered to Krishna. Nobody in the past or in the future did like gopis. So in the Vaikuntha world, we hear about the chastity of Lakshmi. And also Shastra explains about the chastity of Lakshmi and also other persons in the material world. But this chastity of the gopis, this prema of the gopis is incomparable. Their prema madhurya, their prema is incomparable.
Vaikuntha adi jagat mein bhi sati narikon ki katha varnan hai. Matbhumi se lekar ke Vaikuntha mein Lakshmi adi ki bhi satitva ki katha bhi.
So we hear about the chastity of Lakshmi in the Shastras. But this prema madhurya of the gopis, sweetness of their love, is incomparable, unequaled and incomparable.
Gopiyon ki prema madhurya darshan. Yeh das jas सुदुष्ट जो आर्य पथंच हित्वा संसार में सती नारी अपने प्राण तक दे देगी
सो अ चेस्ट लेड इन दिस वर्ल्ड शी कैन गिव अप हर ओन लाइफ बट विल नेवर गिव अप हर चेस्टिटी
अरुंधति
लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल अरुंधति यू हैव हर्ड
क्या नाम
और अबाउट व्हाट्स हर नेम
नहीं अनुसुआ
Anusuya also, we hear about, Shastra explains about also their chastity.
Brahmaji, Shivji,
Brahmaji
and
Shivji and Vishnu, they came to destroy her chastity, but they couldn't do it. So Shastra also explains. Do you know the story? The story of Anusuya? What have you heard? Tell me about her story. Narada Rishi once,
वैकुंठ में आ गए
He came to Vaikuntha
और अनुसुआ के सतीत्व के धर्म के
बारे में. And he started saying to Lakshmi about the chastity of Anusuya.
वो सतीत्व धर्म के सुन करके.
Listening to her chastity. About her chastity, Lakshmi Devi felt so much jealousy or like a envy, like a jealousy in her heart, like some envy, and she was thinking, "You must destroy her chastity somehow." Bhagavan said, "I'll try." Lakshmi told this to Vishnu, and then Narada also went to Sataloka, and he was talking to Brahmani, wife of Brahma, about the chastity of Anusuya. Then she heard. And then she also became like a jealousy or this enviousness, like jealousy. And then she also, wife of Brahma also told to her husband later, Brahma, please destroy this chastity of Anusuya. He told, I'll try. Then Narada also went to like place of Shiva and started saying to Parvati about the chastity of Anusuya. Then Parvati also said to Shiva later, because she was also jealous, please. She was feeling jealous also, jealous. So she said to her husband, destroy the chastity of Anusuya. Then Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva later, three of them, they came to the ashram of Atri Rishi in disguise of a brahmachari. So the three of them, Lakshmi, wife of Shiva, Parvati, and also wife of Brahma, Brahmani, they became jealous. And they wanted to ask their husband to destroy the chastity of Anusuya. So that their husbands came in the disguise of brahmacharis. Bringing some kamandal water pot in their hands. With dreadlocks, like in disguise of a brahmachari. Then Atri Rishi, the husband of Anusuya, by some reason he was out of the house. For meditation or something, he was outside. So the three brahmacharis came and saying, give donation, begging alms. So Anusuya was alone, but whatever fruit she had in her house, she went outside to give the food, give the donation. Then they say, oh, we don't accept like this. You must be naked, and then you must give her as the alms, like the donation, naked. So she was like, what is this? Then she went for the back door, she spoke to her husband and told, these three brahmacharis came very divine, like figure and nice, like very, they are very like special. And then Atri Rishi in his meditation, he understood, the three of them came, Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. So he told his wife, do whatever they like. Then Anusuya came out and Anusuya, she took some water in her water pot. And then she flew this water on them, become like a boy and then like a small baby. And then three of them, they became like one month old babies, all of them, three of them. So
Brahmani, Sivani, look. इसके बाद कुछ दिन तो बीत गए, दो तीन महीने हो गए. अपने मंत्रपुत करके तीनों की.
So she spoke some mantra and threw this water on them.
एक महीने के बालक.
Oh, you must be like a baby, 1 month old baby. So Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, they became very small, like a naked, small baby, 1 month.
उनके आंगन में रहने. इसके बाद कुछ दिन तो
staying in her house. Then after 2-3 months,
लक्ष्मी दी चिंतित होने लगा, पतिदेव कहाँ गए?
So their wives were worried. What is my husband? Then
वहीं पर रह गए.
Ah, he's there where he went to. Ah, so how can I get our husbands back? Then Narada told, you have to be in the form of brahmacharis now and ask your husband back as donation. So the three devis, means Brahmani, Shivani and Lakshmi Devi, they came in the form of a brahmacharini. So they told to Lakshmi Devi, Anusuya, Bhikshan Dehi, what donation you want? Oh, please give us the three boys back, three babies back.
इतने समय अत्रि ऋषि अपने कार्य आदि समाप्त करके कुटिया में जब आए, देखे तीन.
So अत्रि ऋषि
और उनके छोटे
When he came back, he saw three brahmacharinis and three small small babies. Then he asked, "Who are these three brahmacharinis?" And then she told to her husband, Anusya told, "Oh, these three brahmacharinis are your daughters-in-law." And it's funny, you know, because like the sons are small small babies, like these three baby boys, and the daughters-in-law, they are like grown-up ladies, you know.
तो सारी कथा को सुनाया तब उत्तरी से ने कहा जाओ इन लोगों के
so
आप वापस ले लो
so Atradi she told her to give them back then Anusuya chanted the mantra again and threw the water on the boys and the baby boys and then they left
ये सतीत्व जो है कैसे वस्तु है
so the chastity is something right
तो गोपियां ने क्या
but the gopis what did they do
सबको जलांजलि तिलांजलि दी करके
They offered everything. They sacrificed everything, just seeing Krishna as their most beloved, the life and soul.
भेजुर मुकुंद पद्मी सुति भी विविकम ऐसे केवल देव देवता नहीं
Not only the demigods and demigoddesses, even the Srutis, for thousands of years, was to get this foot dust, this Vraja Prema, they were doing so much austerities, the Srutis.
Then
the Gopaltapani Upanishad, they also got this prem. So here we see this evidence. This prem that Radha and Gopis have for Krishna is the highest. Everyone is eager to get this prem. Uddhav, Brahma, etc. Great devotees. The great dears and nears devotees of Krishna. They are doing so much hard austerity to get this prema of the Vraja Gopis. So, Uddhav. So, Uddhav is praying that this foot dust of Shrimati Radhika means one particle of her bhava or her mood may come in my heart. So, until nowadays, Uddhav is near Radha Kunda. At the banks of Kusum Sarova, the other side of Kusum Sarova, at the Uddhava Kunda, he's making austerities until nowadays. He's doing austerities, but he couldn't. Even the Pandavas also, they did austerities at the banks of Radha Kunda to try to attain, but they couldn't also. So this Radha Prem is so rare. Prabhudananda Saraswati Pad, in the book Radha Rasudhanidhis, he explains.
इसलिए राधा जी के प्रेम प्राप्ति अति बदला तो गौड़ी वैष्णव जो है वही राधा जी के कृष्ण के चरण धूलि प्राप्ति करने के लिए शब्दों वैष्णव चरण अनंत सत्यम तम राधिका चरण देनु अनुस्मरामि हमारे प्रबोधानंद
और प्रबोधानंद सरस्वती पाद
राधा रसुदनिधि
इन हिज बुक राधा रसुदनिधि ही एक्सप्लेन्स
नारद
How Brahma, Shiva, Narada and great devotees, full of prem, premic devotees. They are doing austerities to get the foot dust of Krishna, but still they couldn't even get that. So the foot dust of Shrimati Radhika is so rare. It's rarer than what is already rare. Like it's more rare, like rarer than what is already rare. So to get this mercy of this foot dust of Shrimati Radhika is so rare. So the Gauriya Vaishnavas, they want this foot dust of Shrimati Radhika.
Shivji, अथवा जो बड़े-बड़े उद्धवादि भगवान के नित्य परिकार उनके प्राप्ति नहीं हुई तो हम लोग सामान्य जीव है तो हम लोग कैसे प्राप्ति करें
So even if these kinds of great personalities they couldn't get, what about us, normal jivas, you know, ordinary jivas, what about us then? If Uddhava and if Nitya Parikaras of Lords, like Uddhava, etc., they couldn't even get this mood, how about us, conditioned souls? We are ordinary jivas. How can we attain that then? Maybe you have this doubt in your mind.
ये जैसे ब्रह्मा कोई साधारण जीव नहीं,
ब्रह्मा इज नॉट एन ऑर्डिनरी पर्सन।
हजार ब्रह्मा पद कैसे प्राप्ति होता है?
हाउ टू गेट द पोजीशन ऑफ ब्रह्मा फॉर 100 लाइव्स?
ब्रह्मचर्य ब्रह्म ये क्या बोले वर्णाश्रम धर्म पालन करने पर
यू मस्ट फॉलो वर्णाश्रम धर्म एंड देन यू कैन गेट दिस पोजीशन ऑफ ब्रह्मा।
कोई साधारण नहीं,
इट्स नॉट ऑर्डिनरी थिंग।
तो हम बद्ध जीव,
सो वी आर बद्ध जीव्स,
कैसे प्राप्ति करें?
Like conditioned souls, how can you get? Maybe you have these doubts, isn't it? If even Brahma, Shiva, Narada, Bhishma, they even couldn't get, even them couldn't get, so how can we get?
जैसे एक छोटा बटू होकर, बटू समझते हो? होकर के वो चांद को कैसे पकड़ेगा? नहीं पकड़
सकता। Not possible. Just one second. So
तो आपकी प्रश्न में होकर के वो चांद को आप कहें तो हमें कैसे प्राप्ति होगा? जैसे एक छोटा बटू होकर, बटू समझते हो? होकर के वो चांद को कैसे पकड़ेगा? नहीं प्राप्त कर सकता।
नो, नॉट पॉसिबल।
तो आपकी प्रश्न में यही है।
So your question is,
if
even Uddhava couldn't get, how can we get that? So in this context, it said that, especially in this Kali Yuga, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he's giving this Braj Prema, although it's so rare, it's available. So that's why this Kali Yuga is called Dhanya Kali. Even Brahma and great demigods, they are praying to Lord. Prabhu, please give me birth in Bharatavarsha. Because to be born in Bharatavarsha in India is nothing ordinary. Like Chaitanya Charitamrita explains, to be born in India is not, is so rare. After doing austerities for many, many lives, then you can get birth in India. So those who are born in India and are doing austerities, sorry, doing bhajan under the guidance of Mahaprabhu, how they are great personalities, like how they are great. Because Mahaprabhu gave this, he made the promise. Lord Chaitanya promised. Which promise? He said, I will give Vraja Prem to everyone in this Kali Yuga. So even if you become a little bit having attachment for Mahaprabhu in this Kali Yuga, even if you do a little bit of bhajan in this Kali Yuga, frozen. One sec.
Hey, samana rupme jo bhajan bhi kare.
So if you, even if you do a little bit of bhajan. I don't know what happened.
अरे देन प्रेम बिलाया जिसको देखते हैं महाप्रभु प्रेम प्रदान कर लो। अब तारे विचार न कर लो। इस कलयुग में
चैतन्य इस कलयुग महाप्रभु
अधिकारी है।
He was not concerned who is qualified or not. He was not discriminating, making this discrimination. Mahaprabhu saw the person and gave the prem.
यद्यपि इस कली के धर्म क्या है?
Actually, what is the dharma of कलयुग?
कलि तो और वही द्वापर युग अंत होने के पश्चात।
So after the end of द्वापर युग, कलयुग started. So in the beginning of कलयुग,
कलयुग में कौन आता है तब?
So चैतन्य महाप्रभु came right in the beginning of कलयुग, but he doesn't come in all कलयुगस. Remember that.
अभी तो कलयुग प्रारंभ ही मान लिया जाए।
Okay, now कलयुग just started, isn't it?
कोई 5000 something.
500 years or something. Sorry, 5,000 years or something that Kaliyuga started maybe 5,000 years ago. And Mahaprabhu came in this beginning of Kaliyuga and he promised to everyone, I will give prem to everyone. So this Kali is called Dhanya Kali. Which Kali? Dhanya Kali. Because the human beings have no qualities in the Kaliyuga. But in Kaliyuga, although they don't have any qualities in Kaliyuga, but there is a great quality. What? Holy names. Chanting holy names of God. By chanting holy names, all our papas, sins are destroyed. Destroyed. Automatically, all the sins are destroyed through Nam Sankirtan.
Because
this is the special mercy of Mahaprabhu. Why? You cannot say. Cannot. What is the reason? You cannot, like, because like, God is independent. And He has this special avatar in Kali Yuga, the form of Gauranga Mahaprabhu.
Special person. Special mercy is given.
Some special mercy is being given. You shouldn't doubt. Sometimes I tell one story. There was a rich person who had four sons and he had so much money. So he was thinking, I have so much wealth, so I'll give my money to whom? I'll make some test, like I'll examine my sons and see to which one I can give you this money. So he said, I'll give you 100,000 rupees to each one of you, my sons. So you have to apply in the business and then show to me after 1 year how much profit you got from this money, initial money I gave to you. So after 1 year, the older son came and told my father, so you gave me in the first place 100,000 rupees and now I've given back to you, I've brought back 400,000 rupees, like I multiplied by 4 the initial money. So the second elder son told, oh my father,
कैपिटल जो मुझे दिया था मूलधन और 2 लाख
आई ब्रॉट बैक 300,000 रुपीस ओके 100,000 इट वाज द इनिशियल मनी यू गिव मी एंड 200,000 रुपीस आई आल्सो प्रॉफिटेड
तीसरी बेटा आए तीसरी करके
थर्ड सन केम सेड ओ आई कुडंट डू सो वेल एज लाइक माय एल्डर ब्रदर्स बट आई डिड समथिंग आई जस्ट ब्रॉट द डबल बैक सो
1 लाख रुपया मैंने
So 100,000 rupees, your money back, your initial money, and also 100,000 rupees I also brought as profit. Okay. But the youngest son, he was sitting far away, and he was his hair was scattered, his clothes were dirty. He had some. So his clothes are dirty, his hair was scattered, he had a big beard, long beard, his clothes were also like torn,
शरीर अत्यंत लीन,
his body was so linen skin, like very weak and thin,
दूर बैठे थे,
and he was sitting far away, and
नजर पड़ा,
the father saw him,
छोटा बेटा,
and said, oh, look at the state of my youngest son. Then the father's heart melted. Son, why are you sitting so far? Come here. I also gave 100,000 rupees to you. What did you do? So again he was calling to him. And with great endeavor, the youngest son came and grabbed the feet of his father. And crying, he said, oh my father, I'm so unfortunate because you gave me these 100,000 rupees, oh father. But 50,000 rupees, I just used to my own sense gratification. I drank alcohol. I did so many bad things. So with the other half, 50,000 rupees, I applied in the business, but I completely lost all the money in the business. I don't even have anything to eat. I don't even have clothes. I don't have anything else anymore. I'm so unhappy. I'm so sad, upset. Oh, my father, look at my condition. Look at my clothes. Everything torn and worn out and everything. So my also body is also so skinny, weak. I cannot even walk. Oh, my father, I take shelter of you. Do whatever you want. Listening to this, so that those diamonds, those gold, like the golds, all the money he had, like these special jewels and precious jewels, the father gave to the youngest son. And the other three brothers were thinking, oh my father, why didn't you give to us? Then he said, look, I examined you and I see that you can earn money yourself. Like you can alone, you can earn money. But my youngest son is completely, he cannot, so what to do? So why are you giving to only the youngest son?
तात्पर्य क्या है? ये जो है मानो भगवान चार पुत्र कौन है? सत्य त्रिता दापत्र।
So who are the four sons?
सत्य के कहने लगे, भाई तुम तो कर सकते हो, ध्यान आदि करके सत्य जो कितने जत है तो विष्णु त्रितायं जजते मुखई दापुरे परिचर्चां कलु ये सब विटना है नाम संकीर्तन।
Okay.
सत्य युग में मनुष्य जो है,
sorry, I just come back 2 minutes because I was checking some word.
मैं इनको सारे धन को
So the father said, so the father gave all the money to the youngest son.
जाओ तुम लोग अपने काम करो। मैं देखपरख करके देखा, तुम लोग अपने आप किंतु हमारे ये छोटा बेटा बिल्कुल निदान कह रहा
है। So my young son is so silly, like ignorance is silly.
क्या कर? और मेरे धन यदि तुम लोग कहो जो नहीं पिताजी आप तो ये
But if you say oh father no you, if you're doing this discrimination you should divide by us four so why are you giving only to the youngest son the father said I'm still alive so I'll give my money to whoever I want you cannot do anything
जाओ तुम लोग अपने काम करो मैं देखपरख करके देखा
so you continue working you by yourself by your own endeavors You can do everything, the father told. But my youngest son, he's completely silly. So I'll give all my money to him. So what is the meaning? He's like so ignorant, like he's foolish. So who are these four sons? Satateta Daparakali. So like in Satya Yuga, people can meditate.
केशव कीर्तन नाम संकीर्तन सप्तयुग में मनुष्य जो है ध्यान
सतयुगा ह्यूमन बीइंग्स कुड मेडिटेट एंड द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स दे यूज्ड टू लिव आल्सो फॉर सो लॉन्ग इन सतयुग फॉर हाउ लॉन्ग
1 लाख
फॉर 100,000 इयर्स
दापर युग त्रेता युग में
इन त्रेता युग यू कैन यू रिमूव 1 0 सो पीपल यूज्ड टू लिव 10,000 इयर्स
उसमें दापर युग में क्या बोले त्रेता युग में लोग क्या करते थे
एंड इन त्रेता युग पीपल यूज्ड टू डू फायर सैक्रिफाइस स्वाहा स्वाहा
और दापर युग के मनुष्य के आयु और भी कम हो गया और 1 0 कम हो गया
एंड इन द द्वापर युग रिमूव 1 0 मोर सो हाउ लॉन्ग
1000 वर्ष
पीपल लिविंग फॉर फॉर 1000 इयर्स एंड पीपल यूज्ड टू डू अर्चन
किंतु कलि युग के मनुष्य के
बट ह्यूमन बीइंग्स ऑफ कलि युग
ध्यान यज्ञ और अर्चना आदि करना संभव
It's not possible for them to do meditation.
और कलि युग के मनुष्य का आयु भी
like
कम हो गया कितने हो गए
fire sacrifice and archan and they live even 1 0 less so 1000 less 1 0 100 years maximum
वो भी 100 साल जो हम जीवित रहते हैं
and if you stay alive for 100 years
बहुत मुश्किल
actually so much difficulty
50-60 साल तक कुछ
so
चले जाते
so 50
साल के बाद बुद्धि भी सठी मर जाती
okay after live to until 50 years or 60 years is okay after but after 60 already our buddhi our intelligences
कमतने 60 साल हो गया तुम्हारी बुद्धि सठिया हो
फिनिश योर इंटेलिजेंस आफ्टर 60
प्रकार के ज्वरा व्याधि आकर के
एंड आल्सो मेनी काइंड्स ऑफ डिजीज दे कम एंड
युवा से दे स्टार्ट टू वृद्ध काल
या व्हेन यू आर यंग या बट इट्स गुड
60 साल हो गया तुम्हारी बुद्धि सठिया हो कोई चश्मा से नहीं होते और नाना प्रकार के ज्वरा व्याधि आकर के घेर
And many kinds of disease they come when you're young okay but after 60 years old the body becomes so weak and like is degrading like degrading like dwindling of the body so many disease like for example diabetes and now in Kali Yuga there's another now in Kali Yuga there's even another disease that is like shaking the whole world like
sare vishwa brahmand vishwa ke jo hila diya
like shook the whole world even the great politicians or kings everybody
hila diya
shook everyone this corona
वास्तविक सत्य नहीं
दिस इज ट्रू नो
केवल हमारे भारतवर्ष में नहीं है
नॉट ओनली इन इंडिया
इंग्लैंड अमेरिका में आज तक अभी तक भी लॉकडाउन है
इवन नाउ इन इन इंग्लैंड एंड अमेरिका इज स्टिल लॉकडाउन गोइंग ऑन दे आर फॉलोइंग सो मेनी रूल्स
दे कलि युग में ऐसे से भी रोग बीमारी है
सो सो मेनी डिजीज इन कलि युग द बग टेन एक्सप्लेन्स
समस्त भागों में सब बनो है तो क्या करें वो 100 साल कलि युग में कोई बचा वो भी बहुत सौभाग्यवान है
इफ समबडी लिव्स इन 400 इयर्स इन कलि युग दिस पर्सन इज सो फॉर्चूनेट एक्चुअली बिकॉज़
हो गया तो वो इसके
लाइक
इट क्या तैयार कर दिया जाता है
इट्स सो मेनी लेस पीपल दे लिव अंटिल 100 इयर्स यू नो इट्स सो रेयर इवन टू लिव
80 साल हो गया
तो बस 70 80 इयर्स ओल्ड इज ऑलरेडी यू नो मैक्सिमम
बीमारी है ये भागवत में वर्णन है ये समस्त भागवत में सब वर्णन है तो क्या करें वो 100 साल कलि युग में कोई बचा वो भी बहुत सौभाग्यवान है 100 साल में बहुत कम है 70-80 हो गया तो बोले इसके खटिया तैयार कर दिया जाता है समझ में आता है
सो एन पर्सन इज ऑलरेडी 70 या 80 इयर्स ओल्ड ही इज ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयरिंग इज ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर हिम टू लीव द बॉडी लाइक टू डाई बिकॉज़ सो डिफिकल्ट टू लीव आफ्टर 70 या 80 इयर्स ओल्ड
100 साल हो गया तो बस
फिनिश्ड व्हाट टू डू
इसलिए कहा थे मैं इसलिए इस कहानी को इसलिए सुना रहा हूँ
सो आई एम टेलिंग दिस स्टोरी बिकॉज़ द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स ऑफ कलि युग
नॉट चित्त स्थिर है
दे कैन नॉट
काम क्रोध लोभ मोह मद
दे कैन नॉट कंसंट्रेट देयर माइंड्स दे आर फुल ऑफ काम क्रोध लोभ मोह लाइक लस्ट एंगर ग्रीड एंड बिजनेस एंड एवरीबॉडी इज अनहैप्पी इन कलि युग एवरीबॉडी
दूसरे के ऐश्वर्य आदि
देख व्हेन वी सी
जलन होता
है एवरीबॉडी फील्स लाइक दिस एंविसनेस you know envy and jealousy in Kali Yuga we see other people's prosperity and we feel our heart burn with envy like jealousy in Kali Yuga isn't it? So tell me, what is the quality of the human being Kali Yuga? So, O king, in human beings, the Kali Yuga only have faults, no any quality. So the father told to the other three sons, so you, by your worship, by your dhyan, meditation, by your five sacrifice, you can attain to Lord. But for the Kali Yuga, the human beings cannot attain. Try to meditate. Can you meditate? You sit down to chant your Gayatri mantra, to chant Om Bhurbhuvah, then you fall asleep. But then, or if you don't fall asleep when you chant your Gayatri mantra, your mind is just wandering and wandering and wandering. Like, so when you sit down to chant your Gayatri mantra, so you have to meditate for only 5 or 10 minutes, but it's so difficult to concentrate your mind. You cannot even do that. How possible? So in Kali Yuga is not possible. So for five sacrifice also, in Treta Yuga they used to do five sacrifice, but how to do five sacrifice in Kali Yuga? I'll tell you the truth. When somebody tell me, Maharaj, make five sacrifice, then the first thing before they say like this, Maharaj, but how long will this five sacrifice take? Because I must go to my office, how long will it be? Please finish quickly, you know. So in the beginning, the person is already telling me this. From the beginning, he's already saying, Maharaj. And then when I sit down for the five sacrifice, the also person also sits down in front of me. But then just in the beginning, like for example, his son is like, tan, 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 like baby crying. Then he leaves the five sacrifice and goes attend his baby. So you think it can be like this? And also cannot even find pure ghee, this Kali Yuga. These ingredients of sacrifice must be pure, but in the Kali Yuga they are not pure. So it's not possible to do five sacrifice in Kali Yuga. So in Dwapara Yuga people used to do parichadya, means archan. But in Kali Yuga this worship is not possible. Because if you do your archan and then you play the bell, you know, for the archan, then your neighbor will call the police and will complain, oh, my neighbor is not allowing me to sleep. Then you play the conch. You blow the conch and also... And also the neighbor also chastised, he'll say, oh, you did some noise and my son was sleeping and he woke up. So, in the Western countries, even worse than that, what can I tell you? Even more difficult. So, you burn the incense stick, you're just burning incense, and then the neighbor is also calling even the police, what they are burning, what is this smell? But so they call the police, what they are burning, but in their own house they are burning the meat, and they are eating that meat, burned meat, like cooked meat, like this baked meat or anything, like, and they are thinking that smell is good and they like that. But if you just burn the incense, they will complain. I'm telling the truth. I stayed in England and I stayed in the house of a devotee in England, and next to his house there was another person living. And so when he used to do the arati and burning, like, you know, the burning the incense, like offering incense, so the smell of the incense was coming to the house of the neighbor. So he called the police, the neighbor. Police came. So the police, their complaint was that they were, the devotees in their house, they were burning something which had bad smell and it was coming to their house, disturbing them. Have to stop burning this. But every day the neighbor was what? Was like a, you know, baking the, you know, like the meat, isn't it? Like burning the meat, like cooking the meat, they would say, no, but like burning that meat, and that smell is coming, but नो प्रॉब्लम ना.
हम क्या बताएं?
सो व्हाट कैन आई से? कैन आई से?
विवाह शादी में सारा रात ढम 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 करे बजाते रहते.
सो व्हेन देयर इज सम मैरिज लाइक सॉरी सम वेडिंग सेरेमनी सम पार्टी द होल नाइट दैट नॉइज इज कमिंग लाइक द साउंड्स बट नथिंग.
घर में नाम संकीर्तन एक दिन.
But like no problem, like some sound coming of wedding or of some like a party, but no problem. But one day we do some nam sankirtan small. Then they are like burning with jealousy or envy, or like they are creating problems for the nam sankirtan, like the neighbors, you know. So in Kali Yuga, it's not possible archana in Kali Yuga. So that's why Mahaprabhu told Kali Yuga only nam sankirtan.
जैसे अनुकूल परिवेश है उस अनुकूल परिवेश में नाम संकीर्तन.
सो यू डू नाम संकीर्तन इन द फेवरेबल सर्कमस्टेंस. यू कैन डू कैन चेंट स्लोली और लाइक इन अ लो वॉइस और यू कैन चेंट लाउडली डिपेंडिंग ऑन द सर्कमस्टेंस.
नाम जिलकल कलयुग में नाम संकीर्तन वही नाम संकीर्तन
संकलयुग नाम संकीर्तन बाय नाम संकीर्तन यू गेट द फ्रूट ऑफ ऑल द अदर थिंग्स. यू कैन गेट द फ्रूट ऑफ द मेडिटेशन इन सतयुग बाय चेंटिंग होली नेम्स इन कलयुग. Also you get the fruit of doing five sacrifices in Treta Yuga. And also by doing Nama Sankirtana in Kali Yuga, you also get the fruit of doing Archana in Dwapara Yuga. So you see the great glory of Kali Yuga. You don't need to do anything in Kali Yuga. Just Nama
Sankirtana. इसलिए तो करे चैतन्य महाप्रभु मानो अपने जो प्रेम धन
सो महाप्रभु दिस प्रेम धन दिस सो
सबको प्रदान करे
सो वैल्युएबल वेल्थ ऑफ प्रेम ही इज गिविंग टू एवरीवन.
हरि हि सुंदर देव सन संदीप कदा सदा हृदय कंदे स्फुरतु भव सचिनंदन गौर हरि हमारे हृदय कंदे
सचिनंदन गौर हरि May he always be present in the inner core of our hearts. So if you get this mercy of Guru Sundara, this is our prayer. And how is his growth so magnanimous, so generous? He's giving prem to everyone, although they might be qualified or not, even though they are not qualified. So this great generosity of Mahaprabhu. In Kali Yuga, you don't need to do anything else. Just walking, sleeping, eating, sitting, whatever you're doing. You took shower or not. Just chant holy names. There is no rule, like no rules you must follow to chant holy names. In any condition, you may chant holy names.
Krishna, Krishna, Hari, Hari. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. इसलिए कलयुग में सहज हो गया कि नहीं?
So in Kali Yuga, it's simple or not? So simple, you can attain to Lord.
एक बार नाम करके
If once you chant holy names, all your sins will be destroyed. There's no doubt.
यदि सदगुरु चरणाश्रय करके और मंत्र आदि ग्रहण करे नाम मंत्र आदि उसके फल क्या होगा?
So if you take shelter of bona fide guru and chanting holy names, so what fruit will you get?
अजामिल अपने बेटा के नाम रख
अजामिल ही जस्ट गिव द नेम ऑफ हिज सन नारायण
लेकर के पुकारने पर उनकी क्या गति हुई.
सो जस्ट बाय सेइंग द नेम ऑफ हिज सन ही अटेन टू वैकुंठ
नमः से अजामिल पाइलो वैकुंठ. अजामिल अपने बेटा के नाम रखा नारायण और
सो नारायण जस्ट अजामिल जस्ट गिव हिज सन नेम नारायण एंड देन टाइम ऑफ डेथ ही कॉल्ड हिज सन
वैकुंठ
एंड ही अटेन टू वैकुंठ.
आज जो सद्गुरु चरणाश्रय करके भगवत नाम आदि करते हैं सदाचार पालन तो उनके कौन सा गति होगा आप बताइए.
एंड इमेजिन दोस हु टेक शेल्टर ऑफ बोना फाइड गुरु एंड चेंट होली नेम्स इन दिस कली युग व्हाट बेनिफिट विल दे गेट
लेकर के पुकारने पर उनकी क्या गति हुई वैकुंठ गति है. नमः से अजामिल पाइलो वैकुंठ. अजामिल अपने बेटा के नाम रखा नारायण और अंतिम काल में मृत्यु के समय बेटा के नाम लेकर पुकारा और उससे उनको क्या हुआ वैकुंठ प्राप्त.
So those who take shelter of the guru and chant holy names and follow all the good rules, imagine what destination will they get? Tell me. They'll go even higher. Then Vaikuntha, they will go even up in the like more up, like beyond Vaikuntha, they will go to Goloka Vrindavana. There's no doubt. If you want to go to Goloka Vrindavan, so you must take shelter of Mahaprabhu, his lotus feet, and follow his conceptions and his behavior. There's no need to do anything else. Whatever condition you are, just continue. If you are a grihastha in your house, just continue in your house. I'm not telling you to take sannyas or leave your house. So if you're brahmachari, stay brahmachari. If you're sannyasi, stay sannyasi. Whatever ashram you are, just continue in that ashram. If you are grihastha, just continue that. No need to give up anything. Just chant holy names of Lord.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Isme Mahaprabhu ne kaha diya, Krishna nirna na karo.
Mahaprabhu told, you should not criticize anyone.
Guru Abhagya, Gurudev ki Mortabuddhi.
You should never think Gurudev is a normal human being, some mortal human. You should never think also the name of Shiva can be equal to the name of Krishna. And third is Guru Abhagya, dishonor to Gurudev. You should never think Gurudev is a normal human being. And do Nam Sankirtan. Okay, you're staying in your house, you have babies, you have children, you have wife, son, whatever, mother, father. Serve everyone in your family, it's okay, stay in your house. But constantly, like following rules or like following some habit, like every day, chant holy names.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
I would say like fixed round, like chant holy names, following the rule like this. So, when the time will come, your body will stay, like you'll die, and chanting holy names, you'll go directly to Bhagavad Dham, the abode of Lord. What else do you want to tell me? That's why in the Kirtan explains. Doing bhajan slowly, slowly. When the time will come, means you know, prarabdha karma will be destroyed. So you'll give up your body and chanting the names of Lord. You'll go to the abode of Lord. What else do you want? Tell me. So you may stay in your house, you may stay be sannyasi, brahmachari, whatever.
This,
actually, you stay in the brahmachari ashram or grihastha ashram only because of the favorable environment for you, like according to what is favorable for you. Or maybe sannyasa ashram or vanapasti ashram. But for the Krishna bhajan, this is not important. Or like, not important, I mean, like this is not necessary exactly. Like which ashram are you? Doesn't depend on that. To Bhagavad bhajan. To do Bhagavad bhajan, only one thing is needed, that you have nam nishta, like steadiness in chanting holy names. Enchanted pure holy names.
Pure.
So the last instruction that Mahaprabhu gave was chant holy names and serve Vaishnava, and very quickly you'll attain to Lord. Serve the Vaishnavas and chant holy names. Enough. Then you don't need to do anything else. You already got. If God gave you a good intelligence, good like good brain or mind, then you okay study the scriptures. Otherwise, no problem. Just chant holy names and Vaishnava seva. So this path is so easy. What could be easier than that? So very simple and easy. Now already 5 o'clock. So give the prasad to everyone. I also take. Bring water. It's in the room. I'm happy that all of you are doing bhajan. It's my good fortune that did it said.
Huh?
No, you're so merciful. And so where we go now, Prabhuji? Where we must go? So there's no even a Harikata? No.